some NBA action. Kevin Harlan here, and I'm joined by Greg Anthony, Clark Kellogg, and David Aldridge, who's reporting from the sidelines. We've got the Seattle SuperSonics and the Miami Heat. Here we go. It'll be the Heat off the tip. Let's check out Seattle's starting lineup. Johnson is out there with Sean Kemp. Then it's Hersey Hawkins. Then it's Shrimp. And it's Peyton. And it's the one. Out of hand on it. Here's Shrimp. Shrimp from downtown.
Really love watching Peyton dish it out like that. He's a true floor general who does an outstanding job of getting his teammates the clean looks.
And Hardaway gets it to go. Seattle with the ball. Pass to Shrimp. Over Mashburn. And the basket by Shrimp. Shrimp's got five now. Here's Hardaway. It's good. Only a few seconds into the shot clock.
Yeah, Hardaway just great at pulling up off the dribble. You can't allow him any separation when he's got the ball.
Hawkins passes to Shrimp. They get the rebound.
How about three or four from the floor to start? That's always a good sign.
Now here is Hardaway. And stolen by Peyton. And here we go. Peyton heading to the hoop. Boy, Gary Payton there with a heck of a move.
And early on, they've been nearly perfect from the floor. Just the one miss here on their first five attempts.
On the wing, Hardaway pulls up from the corner, tips it up. He hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
Yeah, Morning just a beast on the glass, using that muscular frame to get into prime position there on the board.
About 2 minutes played here in the first quarter.
Oh, fellas, that was vicious. Two-hand monster slam.
Guys, I don't think there was anyone who could have stopped him on that one.
Well, guys, I'm glad they didn't try because I don't want anybody to get hurt out there.
He gets that one. And here is Hardaway. To the middle. Here's Morning. The teardrop falls in. Morning's got his second best.
Boy, the interior game of Morning. Really strong, solid. Excellent at getting quality shots in close.
13 feet away. Johnson can't hit.
Very dangerous to leave a guy like that open. Lucky right there.
Here's Mashburn. Yes, and it's Hardaway picking up the assist.
And Hardaway always looking to incorporate his teammates. You can see him keeping his eyes moving in order to make sure he's ready to deliver to the open man.
Hawkins bangs home the J.
Nice stroke from long range. And if he keeps getting those opportunities, he better take it.
Marley, all sorts of time. That shot off. And it's the Sonics taking it the other way. It's off his foot. And it's being called a kickball. Osteen has checked in for Miami. Perkins has checked in for the Sonics. And it's Seattle with the ball. Kemp can't hit.
And he didn't punish them for the weak coverage there, but they can't.
Marley kicks to Morning from 13. Austin, great positioning on the putback.
And of the last six baskets, five have come on the interior. This is just smash mouth physical basketball, guys.
And the basket by Shrimp.
Yeah, there's 6 points on consecutive three balls. They're finding holes now in the deep.
Hardaway against Peyton. Fires it up. And Hardaway gets it to go. Hardaway has got 6 points. And it's Seattle with the ball. There's the triple. And again, Seattle with the triple.
And the triples keep falling, guys. That's three in a row.
I think they're playing too soft on the perimeter. They can't stay so soft. They've got to get up into the shooters here.
And pushing it up. Here's Seattle. Kemp with the jam.
about the determination there from Payton. The glove showing off his fast hands yet again.
1:43 left in the first quarter of the game. It's taken away by Payton. On up the court. And he gets the bucket. Kemp's got his second basket of the night. And let's get your take, guys, on the hustle stats for Seattle.
Boy, they've really amped up the pressure at the defensive end, guys, and they've piled up the steals in the early going.
And the other thing that's been equally as effective is the fact that they've gotten out on the fast break. A lot of points coming in transition.
And that one's good by Marlon.
He's looking confident right from the opening tip.
On the first time out of the game called for Seattle. He's checked in for Kemp. Wingate comes in for Shrimp. Askew's checked in for Hawkins. And it's McMillan in for Gary Payton. Here's McMillan. Here's Askew. Traps in the tray.
Yeah, they're relying on their three-point shooting and getting pretty good results.
The Heat trail by eight. Stolen. And the officials into the backcourt violation. Not very careful there. Seconds left to play in the first quarter. Morning passes to Mashburn. Pass to Morning. And there's the 3 second call. This one on the defense. The Heat shooting their first free throw attempt on the night. And the technical free throw is good.
That's his second foul already, and that's going to force him to tone down his aggression defensively.
Miami shooting their second and third shots at the line right here. No good on the free throw. The second from the line. Here's McMillan. There's 42 seconds left in the first quarter. Lets it go from the wing, and he buries that one, trailing the rim on the way down. Askew's got five.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket coming off a free throw.
Well, when you look at the assist total, hey, they're clearly the better team.
And he is really in a zone right now, playing and scoring with confidence.
3 second difference between shot clock and game clock. No good on the three. The Heat trail by six. That's the Heat out of play. Morning inside. He's covered by McMillan. Whistle blows. Bucket is good. He'll have a chance at the line to make it a 3-point play. The Heat shooting their fourth attempt at the free throw line right here. And the free throw, no good.
You know, Morning plays with such passion. I love it. A leader both on and off the floor. A very imposing center.
We've got more NBA basketball coming your way in just a minute. Here's Askins.
comes up and lays it nice and easy. Yes, Rose got the opening basket here in the second quarter for Miami. Askew passes to Perkins. Perkins drills the three.
You know what? The nice thing about Perkins is he can score at all three levels. At the rim, mid-range, and from the three. Right there.
You see the range. And finish off by Brown. When he gets into that area. He is, and he picks the simple one-hand stuff to get the 2 points.
Hey, guys, I know I'm stating the obvious here, but those could be an important 2 points considering how close this game is.
And really, as the three-pointers keep dropping, you get the sense that the frustration is mounting for the defense.
Yeah, they either have been unwilling or unable to take that shot away.
Johnson, he's checked in for Sam Perkins. Here in the second quarter with a little over a minute gone. The pass to Mashburn. Got a piece of it. Back to Brown. Brown jams it in.
Hey, guys, I don't know that this is the time for that kind of flair. In a close game, the important thing is to get the 2 points, not necessarily the dramatics.
Oh, come on. He had to go for that, didn't he? My goodness.
Yeah, I'm with you, Kevin, there. I mean, I can't fault the guy for adding a little flavor to things. I'm fine even if he didn't miss it. I don't mind taking a chance to spruce it up a little bit.
Seattle shooting their first shots from the free throw line tonight. The first one falls. And so he hits both. The Heat trail by five. Tipped away. They're running. Nice shot by McMillan.
What a leader and terrific defender. McMillan forces the turnover that gets them into the fast break. And that's foul number two. And maybe you don't sit in at this point, but you really have to be careful to not pick up another beforehand.
And the Heat making a change here. Marley's checked in. Now, here's Brown. He has five. To the left wing, Johnson over the hill. Here's Austin, and yes, it's good.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times. Easy bucket in the paint.
Well, listless and lifeless at the defensive end. I mean, especially inside, they've really got to pick up that interior defense.
Having a lot of trouble stopping the three-point shot.
And they're not making up for it with their own shots from deep either, so that's a double-edged sword there.
Here's Haskins. And they wasted no time getting those 3 points back.
Well, we come at us, and we're coming right back at you.
A little back and forth from long range. I love it. That's a terrific answer there.
Nice shot by McMillan.
Can't be thrown any better. That bounce pass hit him right in stride.
Passes it to Cronin. Wide open. Count that one.
Yeah, I like the creativity there by Marley. Gotta like seeing him tip passes across the court.
Seattle calls timeout. As the teams head into this timeout, a chance for the coaches now to map out some plays for the next few minutes and a chance for the players to rehydrate with some Gatorade. That's important if they want to make sure they don't wear down later in the game.
Absolutely. Over the course of a game, you have to stay hydrated.
Hardaway's checked in for the Heat. Big group substitution here for Seattle. Ben's checked in for Brakowski. Shrimp comes in for Askew. Percy Hawkins checked in for Wingate. And it's Payton in for McMillan. Hawkins shot good.
And they're getting their points now almost exclusively from the triple. Four of their last five makes are from beyond the arc.
And Greg, it's hard for me to watch this. I mean, the defense practically giving them those shots.
Finished off the break. Hawkins has got the lead up to 11 now for the Suns.
You gotta love his hustle, leading the defense. No time to react.
And you know, you don't get those buckets, guys, when you're quick to get out on the break. Get that ball.
Strong to the chin, trying to get his guys going.
Hard not to get motivated, GA, right when your teammate makes that kind of play.
Yeah, you know, when you're looking to close the gap, you need guys who will take it upon themselves to step up, take the initiative, and make something happen.
Hawkins against Marley. And here in the second quarter of action as we approach 4 minutes play. Hardaway with a wide open look. Brown. Great D that time from Kemp.
The defense ready for him on that possession. They had to be, because he is so strong in the paint.
And the basket by Shrimp. And Miami calls their first timeout of the game.
That was a good time to call the timeout to try to settle everybody down and get back into their offensive rhythm. They've been coughing up the rock an awful lot.
Morning's checked in for Austin. The Heat trail by 13. Ball stolen. Pushing it up. Pushes it down to finish the break.
That's a double whammy, guys.
That's right. A great defensive play, then the emphatic stop.
Well, turning defense to offense, we talk about it all the time. Try to hit your opponent at the other end before they can set up the defense.
Really nice job to convert the putback opportunity there. I mean, he stayed with that play from start to finish. That's something we say about him a lot. He missed that one, but I've seen him drill shots from that distance in warm-up.
That looked to me, guys, like a heat check. Maybe a step out of his range.
And wait to finish and cut into that lead a little bit.
But look at the basket, guy, still shaking.
Well, I tell you what, he loaded up as much power as he could behind that two-hand. At the offensive end, he's been assertive and efficient, guys. A big reason why they hold this lead right now.
The footman controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
You know, if you're only looking at the way he's played offensively, you'd think his team would have the lead.
Here's Payton trying to get open as Johnson, and it's Payton. That time on the assist by Hawkins. Hawkins has got four assists in the game. The Heat trail by 15. Here's Haskins. Down low. And knocked out by Morty.
Boy, the aggressiveness of Morty inside, I like it. I mean, when he's this deep, looking to throw it down.
Releases. And misses it off the right side of the rim.
They've been the better rebounding team by a healthy margin, but it hasn't been enough.
Yeah, you know, they're hustling and giving a good effort, that's for sure. But unfortunately, the execution has been lacking.
We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Good on the triple. Hawkins has got 10 points now just in this quarter.
And then he's starting to show that killer instinct this quarter, looking to extend the lead.
Dan Marley on the win. The putback, it's good on the putback.
And look at it, a significant portion of their offense coming on those second chance opportunities.
Yeah, they played with more hunger. Very impressive with the effort they put on the glass. I like that tenacity.
In the corner, Hardaway with it. Keeps it alive, controls the rebound, and puts it back up and in. Morning's got 18 points.
I love the determination he showed here, getting himself into a new position under the glass.
With the presence of mind to know just where the rebound was going to come down. Well timed.
And then the nifty touch to tip it in as well.
And we've reached halftime in this one. Sonics lead by 12. Time now for the halftime break, with the third quarter soon to follow, right here on 2K Sports.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey again, everybody. I'm Ernie Johnson. Shaq is here. Kenny's here. You're watching the NBA Halftime Show on 2K Sports. Taking a look at the SuperSonics. Shaq, let's get your insight on the visiting team.
I don't think anyone expected to see such numbers from the bench. I'm impressed. It's what they needed, the jolt they needed. Wow, I never knew their bench. Matter of fact, I don't even know any of their players coming off the bench. Man, keep going, bench guys.
Kenny, what you think about Miami?
Well, the perimeter D, it's just too loose. I mean, there's no excuse for letting the team rain that many threes on you. And at that high a percentage, guys aren't fighting through screens. They're not staying with their shooters. They're not helping out. Just bad basketball on a defensive end. They've got to tighten it up on a high level in the second half.
Thanks for joining us, folks. We're now just a few minutes away from the start of the third quarter.
Well, we've got a second half of basketball for you. We think it's going to be pretty good. A big comeback, though, is needed for this game to be competitive, and it probably has to happen quickly. On the court for Seattle, Hawkins is out there with Payton. Then it's Shrimp. Then it's Johnson. And it's Kemp in the four-man position. The Heat trail by 12. Hardaway with it. Now Payton defended. And the dunk by Brown.
Ball distribution was there. I mean, outstanding work all the way around.
Brown's gone 3-for-4 here from the field. Hardaway, no jam. The shot's good. Brown making the play. Brown's got his third assist on the night.
Boy, how fast Hardaway gets inside is something to watch. Really excels driving all the way to the rim.
Hawkins shot good.
Taking it up strong against size. He does not lack for confidence.
That's well done there. I mean, don't even give him a chance to get to the block. Get in tight and finish at the rim.
Miami with the ball. The Sonics getting the bucket. With possession. At one point, they led by 16. On the top of the key. And it's Miami with the rebound. Austin's got his fourth rebound in this one. Here's Mashburn. Banked in off the glass. Mashburn's got six.
And how about the terrific use of the crossover there to just throw the defender off balance?
Out of bounds.
Out of bounds. Miami takes possession. Six. Inside, here's Trotty, and it's good, assisting on the play with Hardaway. Trotty's got his second basket of the game.
And they are attacking the rim and getting great results.
And how? I mean, they're taking this defense to task, taking them to school. Every one of their last 10 points have come in the paint.
Here's Kim. Offensive rebound, Askew. And there it is for him. Askew's got his third bucket of the night.
Well, I love the way he goes after it there. I mean, you got to respect that. He's rewarded for his efforts of pursuing the ball.
And denied. He sends him right off the glass. Kemp passes to McMillan. Jacks up a three. And Crotty pulls it down. Not quite enough to finish. Under 3.5 minutes played here in the third quarter. Here's Askins. Let's it go from deep. Rebound by McMillan.
Boy, I'm absolutely shocked he didn't get that one to go. Usually he's money from deep.
Here's Huskew. Nice shot from the wing. And it's an 8-point Seattle lead.
I love the ball movement there. He put that on a silver platter. Just served him up.
To the paint. Here's Huskew. Count the basket. The assist.
Oh, they own the interior right now. 10 straight points coming from inside.
Well, constantly finding lanes to the basket, getting great looks inside.
Trains the three-pointer. Boy, from the looks of it, it appears the defense is fine with him taking that shot, but he makes them pay when they do.
Pass break, here we go. And Warren sends it back.
How about the reach of Warren? Very impressive, but very long, too. The elite shot blocker. He does a good job timing his jump.
And cutting into the lead with the big one-hand throwdown.
That's how you get your team back into it.
That might indeed ignite a spark in this team.
The Heat trail by 7. 1:12 left to play in the third.
Here's Crunk. 5 points in the game.
And listen, sometimes even the best of us are going to miss the easiest of opportunities.
Here's Wingate, and it's good off the glass. Wingate's got 8 points.
I mean, even he was surprised to be that old.
Here's Crunk. He's covered by McMillan. And he uses the glass on the way. And the Sonics lead by 11.
And unfortunately, we've seen a few too many of those. A lack of concentration, a turnover, and an easy bucket in transition.
Here's Crotty. He beats Jamorny. Up in, and that's his 10th fake in the contest. He has only taken 13 shots.
Just no resistance on the inside. That's their 5th consecutive make in the paint.
And Greg, those looks they're allowing are almost automatic.
Here's McMillan. He's got 7. And again, Seattle with the triple.
He drilled 1 from deep in the first half, doing it again here in the second.
The Heat trail by 12. Shot from 12. The shot's good from Friday. 7 points in the game.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
And on the flip side, Greg, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior. They've got to offer more resistance here.
It's been this way since halftime. Tremendous production from beyond the arc.
Boy, it's been a 3-point barrage. They came out gunning and not stopped.
So it's Seattle. 13 points up at the end of the period. They've excelled in the open court. Their transition game has allowed them to build this healthy lead. We'll return shortly. State Farm assist of the game.
It's just true artistry right there. I mean, great decision on where to go with the ball, and how about the perfect delivery.
And they'd love to see every possession end this way. True team basketball.
And we reach the fourth quarter in a game that may be already out of hand. And it's the Heat with the ball. Trailing by 13. A moment now to reset the lineups. Back to us by Gatorade. All fueled up here for the fourth quarter. On the court for the Heat, they've got Marley. Warning is out there with Brown. And it's Crotty in at the guard position. Fouled in the act of shooting. Gets the bucket anyway. So a 3-point play chance for him. Johnson is checked in for the Sonics. And breaking down some numbers here, the hustle stance for the SuperSonics.
Defensively, they played with a lot of energy, and the steals we've seen are a result of that aggressiveness.
They haven't wasted time getting the ball up the court tonight either, and it's resulted in a lot of fast break points.
That's the morning to the inside. Here's Askins. Got a piece of it, and they're able to recover. Goes back up. That one doesn't drop. And it's the Sonics taking it the other way.
And you know what? He's just not on his game, no doubt about it. Their deficit isn't totally on him, but he has not been an asset for his team. And nice job taking what the defenders gave him. But these guys need a gut check right now.
Well, that's exactly the kind of defense that got them into the hole.
knocks down the three ball.
And he's shaking off that slow start, giving them a boost here in the second.
Seattle leading by 13. Here's Hawkins. Trying to answer back, but that three is off the mark. They've been a little too casual with the ball out there.
Yeah, but you can't force that square peg into the round hole. Oftentimes, you just got to make that first simple pass and get a rhythm from that.
Out of bounds, Miami takes possession. And Miami will get a change here. Hardaway's checked in. And so Brown will bring it up for the Miami Heat. Hardaway goes in. They shoot again, and the rejection by Perkins. Hawkins with it. Hardaway picks him up. The shot by Hawkins, no good. The Heat trail by 13. Pass to Askins. Some nice ball movement here by the Heat. They get it again. Brown, good.
Man, he's got such a great touch and feel around the basket. He made that reverse look easy.
Launches a three. Good D by Hardaway.
After connecting on one three-pointer in the first half, he hasn't added another one since.
That cuts the lead to single digits. Marley's got four this quarter.
Marley, boy, I tell you what, he does a nice job being creative inside, exploiting any holes close to the basket.
Time called here, the Sonics decide to talk it over.
Yeah, things not going their way, and he wants to just try to talk this one over.
And you know what, guys, if for nothing else, just to slow things down a little bit, change it up somewhat.
Let's go down to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, over the last break, I got a chance to hear what the SuperSonics head coach said to his team. His point to them was that they put themselves in the position to succeed and that this is their game to lose. So he needs to see full concentration out of every guy on the court to finish this one off. Kevin?
Just a little under 2.5 minutes have passed now here in the fourth. Drains it from beyond the arc.
And that's another three. And if really, if the defense is hoping that they don't heat up from out here like they did in the first half, they may be in for a real bad spot.
Here's Brown. And the call on the shot sends him to the line. And the first one drops. It helps the pace of the game with the NBA recently modifying the shot clock rule that after an offensive rebound, it doesn't go back to 24. It goes now to the new number, 14 seconds.
Well, I really like the rule because you don't have to bring the ball over the half court line, which is 8 seconds, so it makes sense. And it does speed up the game, in my opinion.
Hawkins can't get that one to fall.
And the stroke definitely lacking confidence this quarter. Nothing on target.
And finished off by Perkins.
Well, if you don't take care of the ball, fellas, that's what can happen.
Absolutely, Greg. That makes the turnover even more painful.
What? You mean the throwdown at the end? I'll tell you what, fellas. I mean, the highlight show are going to pain them even more.
And didn't need anything fancy there, but didn't need to.
Nope, his only concern right now is getting the points on the board. I don't mean style points.
Hey, I thought there was some style there, guys. What are you guys looking at? I mean, it was still a pretty sweet, flavorful one-hand flush.
Morning, shot is good.
Major dominance, and it comes so easily for him. Fantastic at getting to his spots on the floor.
Beyond the arc, and Peyton gets it to go on the assist by Shrimp.
Yeah, Shrimp showing you some nice awareness there, Kevin. I mean, he's dependable when it comes to finding his open teammates.
And the shot goes in.
And you see the ability to rise and fire from mid-range even against that length.
You know, guys, if they're inside, that shot probably gets blocked. But from mid-range, I mean, he's able to get it off over the bigger defender there.
Pushing up 4-on-3. Here's Askins. But they'll get another chance.
You love how Utah has risen to the challenge throughout this one.
Hey, defense is taking a back burner, secondary on the marquee, but who doesn't love a game like this? Let's go. I like offense.
And the three ball is good.
Timeout.
Hawkins has got 11 in the second half.
Well, and this has been their strategy throughout the fourth period. We'll see how it pans out.
You know what? Teams can get a little three happy down the stretch sometimes. Letting it
clock.
And the Heat call time here. They trail by 13. There's 1:54 left in the fourth quarter. And now we've got a moment for our Jordan player of the game, Percy Hawkins.
Yeah, his performance has been a jaw-dropper. He must have been feeling great coming into the building tonight. Because once he hit the court, it was all working for him. He was in a zone.
Teams need contributions from everybody to win on the road, not just the stars. And he's done more than his share tonight, an outstanding performance. There's 1:54 left to play here in the fourth. On the way.
Mismatch, you've got to send help defensively.
Shot on the wing, and Seattle with another.
And that's just cold-blooded right there. He's taking no prisoners.
Guys, when you're this hot, it's elementary. Let it fly. Keep staying at it.
Plenty of space. And then Schreff comes up with the rebound.
I didn't see that miss coming. I mean, he's usually been money from that range.
The three. They get it back. Tries again, and Kemp puts it in.
Late in the game, up big, they continue to attack.
I don't think you want to get loose and sloppy or ease up, but it is time for them to start using that clock a bit.
Hardaway from outside. That doesn't go either for Hardaway.
It's really a tale of two quarters. Shot it so well in the last, but this one can't get anything to fall. And it's still a rare sight to see rebound numbers like the ones he's had tonight.
Boy, he has put in some major work. He's earning his pay, for sure.
And the Sonics with possession. Here's Kemp. Bank shot, no good. And Miami has possession. 15-point game. Marley, that's tipped. But they get it back. Brown, and it's Brown on the follow.
Excellent awareness of where to be on the offensive boards. He did it with great position.
And here's Peyton. He'll bring it up for Seattle. Kemp with the bucket. And the Sonics lead by 15. 23 seconds left in the fourth quarter. They get a hand on it. Hardaway for three. It's hauled in by the Sonics. Here's Hawkins. The shot's good on the assist by Johnson. Hawkins has got 31 points.
Saw the opportunity to put this away and did not turn it down.
And, you know, this run shows what kind of attitude this team has. I mean, the win is there. Go get it.
So no problem for Seattle as they get the win. This crowd was stunned by the manner in which their team was dismantled.
You know what? Shocking. I don't care what the matchup is. You never expect a road team to come in and just cruise to the kind of win they did tonight.
Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. For David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, and Clark Kellogg, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for being with us. We'll see you next time.